Julia Gillard is hinting that she might try to revive the Malaysia solution, but she faces opposition from the coalition and from within her own party.
We're not alone on the world stage when it comes to dealing with asylum seekers. Try 35,000 in a month for Italy.
This is a matter of the highest priority in the internal debate in Europe.
President Barroso left it there. Not so easy for Julia Gillard. News poll finding 78% of respondents rate Labor's handling of the issue as bad. Her immigration minister still sees merit in the Malaysian people swap.
So you could have another go at Malaysia?
Well, I'm not ruling anything in or out.
Tony Abbott, not so keen.
I think that the Malaysia deal was always a bad deal.
He sees Nauru as the solution and is here to help.
I'm saying that we want to be constructive.
He needs to make it very clear that he is talking about working with the government on offshore processing generally, not on his narrow solution.
The government convinced by the immigration department head. In a memo to staff, he talks of the dramatic effect of past policies involving the very quick removal of people from Australia. The Malaysian solution fits the bill, sending boat people back to their departure point, robbing smugglers of their sales pitch. Julia Gillard's problems won't only be convincing Tony Abbott to back any new legislation. The Labor left is insisting on ditching offshore processing, while the right is demanding a hardline approach. Cabinet now juggling the competing claims. Paul Bongiorno, 10 News.
And Paul joins us now from Canberra. Paul, what chance does the Prime Minister have of reviving the Malaysian deal?
Well, Deb, it will be a real struggle, first of all, in the Labor Party. While the left can embarrass the government and can put some political pressure on, when push comes to shove, the right does have the numbers. The real convincing, the real arm twisting, if you like, will be with Tony Abbott. He doesn't like the Malaysian deal, so that's why the Prime Minister is urging him to be not country-specific, to allow amendments that would then give the immigration minister the power to nominate any country. And any country would, it would seem to me, include Malaysia if the government can pull it off.
Thank you, National Affairs Editor Paul Bongiorno.